Are you glad to be in the house of the Lord?
Yes.
All right. So today, we are going to close with a bang. Tell yourself we are closing with a bang.
Closing with a bang.
Yes, you're going to close with a bang. We have been looking at four things that Christ has been made unto us. And we looked at wisdom as the first thing that Christ has been made unto us. And we say that we have the wisdom of God. All right. So you have the wisdom that you need for 2021.
Amen.
Want to see a son?
Amen.
Say, I have the wisdom that I need
for 2021.
So January, when people are saying that it's a dry month, for you as a spiritual child, as a child of the Lord, we don't have seasons. Every single day is Christmas. Oh, I lost some people there. I say every single day for a believer is Christmas. Can I hear an amen? Can I hear better amen?
Amen.
Did you eat a lot of Donero until the oil is now on your throat? So every single day is a Christmas day for a child of God.
Amen.
And I want you to pray that you shall walk in divine wisdom.
Amen.
That is not a precept for pastors. It's for everybody that is a child of God. That you're meant to walk in wisdom. So the next thing that we learned was what? Righteousness. We say that we have a right standing with God. Can I hear an amen?
Yes.
That now we are in the class of God. Say, I am in the class of God.
I
act like God. I think like God. I speak like God. God never speaks failure, so you should not speak failure.
Amen.
Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
So you live righteously because you are righteous.
Amen.
All right? A rich man lives richly because he already knows he's rich. Same case with a believer. You should know that you are righteous. You are not righteous because you watch a nice movie. You are not righteous because you woke up on the right side of the bed. Those are very nice things, but those are moral codes. You are righteous because of what Jesus did for you and I. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Then last Sunday we looked at what?
Sanctification.
Sanctification. And we said, now that you're justified, there is an inbuilt system in you to tell you, no, don't do certain things. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
That is why you did not wake up and go to a bar. There is a system in you as a new man in Christ that tells you, from now on, you don't step into a bar. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
So say, I have the wisdom of God.
I have the wisdom of God.
Say, I am righteous.
I am righteous.
And I am sanctified.
I am sanctified.
Matter of fact, I forgot to tell you that sanctification basically means also you have been set apart to do God's work.
Yes.
All right?
Yes.
That's another thing you need to understand about sanctification, that you have been set apart to do God's work. For example, my laptop has been set apart to help me preach. Okay? There are many other laptops, but this one is set apart for my specific work. Now, if you're sanctified in Christ to do a specific work, so you don't dictate what you're supposed to do.
Yes.
He's the one that dictates what you're supposed to do.
Yes.
Can I hear better? Amen.
Amen.
Like I said on Sunday, you are not free. You are not that free.
Yes.
You are not that free. You're coming from one law to another law. You're coming from the law of Moses to the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus. Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
So you have the wisdom of God, you are righteous and
sanctified
in Christ. So today we look at what?
Redemption.
We look at the topic called redemption. Alright, 1 Corinthians chapter number 1 from verse number 30. That's where our key text is.
Mm-hmm.
1 Corinthians 1. Let's go to verse number 30. We are getting to buy our TV screen very soon. But I have loved the fact that now you can read. Now you can read what? Your Bible. You can remove some things, please. Now you are able to read your Bible. You know, when you're coming to church, 1 Corinthians 1:30. 1 Corinthians is in page 1417, if you're using the same Bible as mine. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Lift your Bible up. Say, this is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
Are you sure it's your Bible?
I am.
Alright. This is my Bible. It is the Word of God.
It is the Word of God.
I will become what it says I will become.
I will become what it says I will become.
My mind is made up. I will never be the same again. In Jesus' name, and God's good people say it. Holy Spirit of God, use me to reveal your word to your people. I ask for your grace, and I ask for the spirit of revelation to rest upon us. In Jesus' name. Amen. 1 Corinthians 1:30 says, but of him are you in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, and righteousness, and sanctification, and redemption. Can you read your version? One, two, go.
It is because of you that you are in Christ Jesus,
uh-huh.
who has become for us wisdom from God, that is our righteousness, holiness, and redemption.
Okay. Yako nimesikia kama inasema sacrament. Anyway, I'm joking. Are you ready to learn?
Yes.
Today I'm going to drop some heavy stuff, but I hope you will listen to the audio again and again. And if you have a question, please ask. All right? So, we are looking at redemption. What is redemption? Redemption is the action of saving or being saved from sin, error, or evil. Redemption is the act of saving or being saved from sin, error, or evil. Another definition, redemption is the action of regaining or gaining possession of something in exchange for payment or clearing a debt. Definition? The action of saving or being saved from sin, error, or evil. The second one, the action of regaining or gaining possession of something in exchange for payment or clearing a debt. Okay? So, when you take a loan, and that's not your portion, in Jesus' name, unless the Lord leads you that way. But when you take a loan, for example, with M-Shwari, you are already a debtor to who? M-Shwari. When you pay the loan, you have done what? You have redeemed yourself. Is it making sense?
Yes.
So anytime you have an M-Shwari loan, you are actually a slave to M-Shwari. But when you pay the loan, you actually redeem yourself from being a slave to M-Shwari. Is it making sense?
Yes.
So anytime somebody has a loan with a bank, an institution, they are doing what? They have sold themselves, so to speak, to that institution. So when that institution says the interest is now 50%, there is nothing you can do. Silikweli?
Yes.
Alright, now listen to this, because now it's gonna get heavy. All revelation begins in the book of Genesis and ends in the book of Revelation. If you will ever want to know anything that God talks about in his word, trace it first in the book of Genesis. You will see it in Genesis, somewhere in the middle it will appear, and then in the book of Revelation it will also appear. Now, you also need to understand that Genesis was written by somebody called who? Who? Who wrote the book of Genesis?
Moses.
And when he was writing the book of Genesis, was he there?
No.
He was not there. But he got it as a vision. Are we together?
Yes.
He got it as a vision. How many of you have ever had dreams? Now, if I ask you a question, when you're dreaming that dream, was it true? Did it appear true?
Yes.
Afterwards?
Yes.
Did it appear?
Yes.
But somehow, for your dream, sometimes you're dreaming, you're driving a Mercedes Benz, and you know your status. Bad boys are just come. So, it is not the Mercedes Benz that is more important. It is the symbolism of a car that is more important. That's what happens with dreams. When you dream that you are in a big story building, it's not the big story building that should fascinate you. It's the symbolism behind this building. That's where the message is. Can I hear a better
wow.
Amen?
Wow.
Oh, have I lost
wow.
it? I'm trying to go very slow. So when you dream, sadly, that you're the American president, chances are, you cannot be the American president. But what is the symbolism behind? It means you're coming to a place of authority.
Wow. You're coming to a place where you will have influence. So sometimes you are mesmerized by what we dreamt. We forget there's a message behind. Rely on the message behind. And let me say this. Every dream should be subjected to the word of God. Can I hear an amen? If you dream, you're a single lady and you're married to you're dreaming, you're getting married to a married man, that is not of God. Even if I was the one officiating in the dream, that is not of God. What is the dream trying to tell you? Hey, watch out, there's a temptation coming. You might fall. Can I hear an amen? Can I hear a better amen?
Amen.
We will be looking at dreams in the light of Christ. You know, you guys know dreams in the light of the Old Testament. You should subject your dreams in the light of Christ. If it is not glorifying Christ, put that dream away. The day I realized these things, I stopped dreaming funny stuff. Wow. So every revelation begins from Genesis, ends with, and I can show you so many revelations there. Tithing begins in Genesis. Sacrifices begin in Genesis. Disobedience begins in Genesis. Death begins in Genesis. What else?
Life
begins in Genesis. The gospel begins in Genesis. Because there is a scripture, I believe in Galatians, that says that God preached the gospel to Abraham. The good news. Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
So that's why I will be introducing these things slowly, slowly. By the time we are hitting 4 years, you will be scholars here.
Yes.
Theologians.
Yes.
You will not be tossed to and fro with every wind of doctrine.
Yes.
Alright? So this is scripture that you know. All of you know this scripture. Genesis 1:26. It says what? Twende kwa Genesis 1:26. Alright. Glenn, help us there. Genesis 1:26. Am I read for you? Let me read for you.
Then God said, let us make man in our image, in our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, over livestock, over all the earth, and over all the creatures that move along the ground.
Mm-hmm. So who decided to create who?
God is the one who decided to create us.
He's the one who decided.
Yes.
So we never decided to be created.
Yes.
Just like he says in Revelation, he has made us kings and priests.
Yes.
Did we decide?
No.
It is him that decided we become kings.
So
oh, that is powerful.
Wow.
I never chose to be a king. He decided to be a king.
Yes.
All right. So he says here, then God said, now in the Hebrew, are you listening?
Yes, sir.
In the Hebrew, the word God there is plural. It means, then God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit said.
Amen.
So you see, the Spirit of God was in creation, and the Son was in creation, and the Father was in creation. So then God said, let us, you see, plural, let us make man in our image. What is the image of God? He is a spirit. So he began by what?
By the spirit.
Got it. So he began creating man where?
The spirit man.
Let us create man in our own image. According to our likeness, because we are spirits. Alright? And let them have rulership. Let them have. Listen, twende pamoja. Let them have authority, rulership, and dominion. So where do you begin to dominate?
The spirit.
From your spirit.
Oh. Wow.
From your spirit. That's where you begin to dominate. Twende. Mm-hmm. Dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, over all the earth, and
every
creeping thing that creeps on the earth. So God created man, where?
In his own image,
that's verse 27. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. Okay? Yes. Then God blessed them. Yeah. And God said to them, be
fruitful
and amesema vizuri verse 27. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him male and female. But hold on. We know that the woman was created in chapter number 2, uko chini. So the woman was not created. So inside the man was the woman. Inside the man was the woman. Because in the creation, when now the woman is coming, the man has to be put on a deep sleep. Then a rib has to be taken. And now God has to do his work. So inside the man was the woman. That's why we have a woo for a man. Tuko pamoja. It's going to sink slowly. Turudi tena. Sasa naona umepotea. Alright. Let me show you. Let me show you. Can I show you?
Yes. Show us.
Alright. And the Lord said, chapter 2, verse 18, he says, and the Lord said, it is not good that man should be alone. But in Genesis 1:27, he created man and woman. Then here he's saying, it is not good for a man to be alone. Now he wants to manifest the woman. The woman is somewhere in the spirit world, somewhere. Now, anataka mlete into the physical world. Now, for somebody to come into the physical world, they must come through a body. And this body must be a man. Umeshika? Alright. It's good. Kishika? Ujashika? Okay. What have you not gotten?
Okay. Start from after saying that it's not good for man to be alone.
He says here, and the Lord said, it is not good that a man should be alone. I will make him a helper comparable to him. Out of the ground the Lord God formed every beast of the field, every bird of the air, brought them to Adam to see what he would call them. And whatever Adam called each living creature, that was its name. So Adam gave names to all the cattle, to the birds of the air, to every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was not found a helper comparable to him. Genesis 1:27, we have seen that God first created the spirit man. Sindio? Now, for this spirit man to come to earth, for him to be legally, to be a legal what, citizen on earth, he cannot come as a spirit.
Yes.
He must come as a body. So inside Adam, there was Eve. But how do you remove Eve from the spirit man? You give them a body. That's why Adam has to sleep. We remove her. We form her. Something, and then the spirit comes in.
Not something, a very nice...
Yes. I'm sorry. It's the deep revelation. Yes, yes. Then? Yes. It's a symbolism of you're coming from me.
Oh.
You're an extension of me.
Okay.
That's why a woman. That's why a woman is a helper. Yes.
Is that why Jesus had to die for the church to come out?
Now you're getting it. Now you're getting it.
Oh, yes.
So, and now we have the grace. That Elisha, that's now redemption. That's redemption now.
Come again.
Sally, explain that point. I don't think I can live recording. That's why Jesus had to die for the church to come out. Because in Ephesians he says we are his bones. We are his flesh. So, if you understand Genesis in the light of Christ, this Bible inakuwa tamu sana. Tuko pamoja?
Yes.
In our heat, turn it home. All right. It's okay. Ask your questions. All right. Can I send them to you later?
Yes,
I will give them to you. So that, because we have a lot to cast, and I don't know whether we'll finish today, but hata kama tutamalizia, tutaendelea tu, sindio?
Yes.
All right. So, we have noticed
The dominion is in the spirit. Is it true?
Yes.
Because he created them in their image. Image of God is spirit. Mm-hmm. All right. Let me try to find something here. Now let's look at verse number 8 of Genesis 2, verse number 8. The Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had. But in Genesis 1:27, he says he created. He says he has created. So this second formation here is now the body. Are you getting it? Because the body ndio alipumua, akaanza kukua a living soul. I hope sijawatupa. Genesis 1:27, ame create the spirit man. Genesis 2:8, ame form. Because up until a form hapa, Eve hezi kama. Jo atatoa rib wapi. Sini kweli? Alright. So here he now forms the man. And now puts the spirit man is inside the man. Are we together?
Yes, sir.
Tuko pamoja? Hey, tuko pamoja?
Yes.
Fei.
Umejiona
Genesis. Okay. Now, this is now getting interesting. So, man has been formed. Eve, the first supermodel, has been formed. Now, this tells us, Mr. Mashanga, that we are the only creation. Adam was the only creation. Adam and Eve was the only creation that could bring forth souls that were eternal. So, mutoto wote mwenye alipitia kwa Adam na Eve, it means they were eternal spirits. I'm really slowing down. I'm really slowing down. Are you getting it? So, meaning, Cain akikam, akikufa, ni body imekufa, but spirit iko. Abel, the same, all the way baka kwa Glen. Are you getting it? So we are the only creation in the entire world that can bring forth eternal beings. That is how dominating we are. That is how God has made to place. That is so much power. And I'm going somewhere. That's why I'm building this picture in your mind. So to may realize we are the only creation, because when a dog dies, it is dead. The chicken that you ate a few days ago, well, it is dead. He meant a paradiso. Paradiso. Can I hear an amen? But now, out of all these things, guess what? Man sinned. Now, it's going to get interesting. Yeah, amen. Man sinned. But remember, Glenn, that in Genesis 1:27-28, he has been given dominion over everything, including the devil.
Because he was a creature.
He was a creature. He was among the creatures. He was given dominion over him. Now, what are you wanting to say to me? Allow me to Kiswahili, Kizungu, Sheng, so that I can bring the point home. Understand, Evie. By the time Genesis 1 in a happen, the entire God na shaito iliko isha happen. Because kama hige kwa ime happen, then Genesis chapter 3 ayezi make sense. When you now the serpent comes to tempt them, it has already happened. It has already happened. The war with God and Satan has already happened. Amefukuzwa kwa sababu alikuwa anataka kiti ya God. So at the back of your mind, usitupe hiyo notion, amejam juu alikuwa anataka kiti ya God. Now this God has created a being and then has given him the power that I wanted all along. So this guy has a grudge.
He does.
I wanted this thing, you pissed me off. Then you gave those hooligans. Those people who are unthankful. They don't even love you.
They don't worship you.
You give them that thing that I wanted.
Now you will see what I will do. So this guy comes in Genesis chapter number 3. Tuko pamoja? Are you learning today? He comes to Genesis chapter number 3. Now the serpent was more cunning than any beast of the field, which the Lord God had made. So, he's a creation. God created Satan. He never made him.
He created him.
Okay. He's a creation of God.
Okay.
But for him to change to be Satan, from Lucifer to Satan, it's his, whatever, making. Yeye ndo alijitengeneza. Ju alirebel, anataka kugeuza serikali na bibi yake. Akaambia Buddha, shia. God never even lifted up a hand. That's what the Bible tells us. We'll see it, yeah? So, here he comes. Now, this is what I was telling my wife in the morning. For a human being to speak to a Satan in the form of a serpent, mumezoeana sana. Mumezoeana sana. Umefika mahali manze ini nyoka, inakuja na kubongesha tu. Now, I was telling my wife, now we know nyoka ziongeagi. But how come it was speaking that time? And where was Adam when this thing was speaking to the wife? Now here, I'm painting something. Remember, we are going to redemption. See here? So I'm painting something so that you see where we are coming from.
Yes.
Now, me thinks, if a snake is speaking to my wife, the first person should be me. She should be her coming to me, telling me there is this creature I've never seen, but he's speaking. So we are not alone in the garden. We are not the only people that can speak. We are not the only persons that can speak in this garden. And then the Adam as the head would have gone where? To God. There is another creation here that is speaking. Should we trust this voice? Hey. Now you're getting it. So both of them, they messed up. The lady entertained the voice. Now can I even shock you even the more?
Shock me.
Let's go to 1 Timothy. Me, I like shocking you by you reading the Bible. 1 Timothy, chapter number 1. Sorry, chapter number 2. Are you in chapter number 2?
Yes, sir.
Tuanzie verse 13. Who's going to read for us so that you don't say my Bible is doctored? Yes, read.
So Adam was formed first.
Okay, wait, slowly. 22 people I call it. For Adam. We know that as a fact.
Yes.
Okay?
Then
Eve.
And Adam was not deceived.
Huh? Adam was not what?
Deceived.
Uh-huh.
But the woman being deceived.
Did you hear that? Yeah. Who was deceived?
The woman.
So Adam was not deceived.
Yeah.
Wow. I will bring it home. Don't worry. I'm gonna bring it home. I just want you to read the scripture. Adam was formed first, then Eve, and then?
Adam was not deceived,
mm-hmm.
But the woman being deceived,
uh-huh.
Fell into transgression. Yeah.
So Genesis here, the woman being deceived. Why was the woman deceived? Because Adam was taking care of everything except the wife. Hey, are you together with me?
Yes.
This guy is naming cattle. This guy is naming lions. This guy is doing everything. So he's so wise. So you wait. Because if you're naming things that you can't rename again, you're very wise. This Bible says they were walking with God in the cool of the day. Alright? So he should have trained the one that came out of his ribs. It was Adam's responsibility to train Eve that if you need anything here, the voice comes from me. Order.
Order, yes.
God follows order.
Yes.
Can I hear an amen? Now, in our church context, if this is your church family, it is illegal for God to give you a prophetic word from another church, from another man of God to you. Umekutana na yeye tawa na kumwambia, "Thus says the Lord." No, God follows order. God is not a God of disorder. Anytime there is disorder, chaos. So the Bible said, "God, let me kushtua pole."
I also got shocked. So the Bible says what, Velma? Adam is fall, then Eve. Then it says, Adam was not deceived. The woman was. And in deception, they led a transgression. Because deception, and this is crazy. This is crazy. If you're married, if you're what? And you're getting married, you must be one.
Wakati amko pamoja hivi, you are a target.
The serpent will come. Did God say? Did God really say? Are you sure he said?
He'll cast doubts into you. Sawa, tuachane na wamama. Tukuje kwa wazee. The Bible says what? Adam was not
deceived.
Why do you think he was not deceived?
Because he hasn't. He was the one given
the authority.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. You're getting there.
And the laws, you should not do this and this.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
The
responsibilities. All right. By the time he's naming these things, Eve is not in the picture.
Yeah. Yeah.
But mumesahau kitu. He has been given dominion.
Dominion.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
So did Adam name the serpent?
That's a good question.
Because if he did, he would have known his gay dogs.
Have you read "And All Creeping Things"?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Wow.
Oh, have I answered you?
Yeah.
Is a serpent a creeping thing?
Yes.
All right. Okay, so, can I continue?
Okay.
So what?
Alikuwa anajua jamaa.
Adam alikuwa anajua. Now, Bible ikisema hakukuwa deceived is because Adam alipeana dominion akionaga, akijua. The woman was deceived. So, shaitani alijua ndio nifikie Adam napitia juu ya training huyu, juu ya juu kitu. Wewe nikikuja direct siwezi kupata. That's why aliongoja mpaka above we talk. Hii ndio weakness yako. Hapa ndio nakushikia. When he was naming, he was doing everything. The devil was silent.
So that means we need to empower our wife.
You need to empower your wife.
Amen.
The greatest downfall of a man is a woman. Empower your wife. Give her the power she needs. Encourage your wife. Build your wife. You're saying it? Can I hear a better amen? Are you learning something?
Amen.
So, the devil knew, if I get Eve, I familiarize myself with Eve. Because I believe the first time Eve aliona kikitu kimekamu, kamombia, Buddha, alitoka unyoya. Tuongea kweli. So the devil had to go back and get another strategy. Maybe alimkujia na rose flower. Kamombia, this is from Adam. Sindio? And that is what happens with temptation. It begins with a carrot. This one. Say, hapana, hapana, najua. Hiyo tuwezi mshika. Tumlete ingine. Even you, itadangoli hivu, fanya macho hivi. Najua, we have now your attention. Now we can speak to you. Yes. The devil will never speak to you unless he has prepared a ground for temptation. He first prepares the ground for a temptation. Then now he comes to speak to you. You know, some of you think that the devil is your best friend. The devil is your greatest enemy. He has mastered you. He knows you. Can I hear an amen? Buddha, see what I'm here.
Yes.
So, he was deceived. Adam was not. Adam gave his dominion. He knew exactly what he was doing. Because if you can name animals, if you can walk with God, you have absolute power. That is power beyond words. So, treason yenye Adam ali commit was what? Was giving
dominion
to the enemy. The mistake of Eve is kuingia box ya shaito. Your box akasukumia nani? Adam. Adam knowingly alijua hii shika. Shika buda, shika. Because ndio apatiane hii dominion. Aliambiwa aje? Did God say that you should not eat anything here? Did God say? Ah, God that you enjoy. Alijua if you eat, you will become wise as God. Hey, I'm already wise. Which other wisdom do I need? I'm naming animals. I'm eating well. I'm living large, man. Which other thing do I need? So anytime, write this down in your heart and in your mind. Anytime there is a blessing coming your way, there will always be a counterfeit. Anytime. There will always be a counterfeit woman, a counterfeit man, a counterfeit business, a counterfeit career. And the devil will ask, did God really say you should not open a bar?
Amen.
Did God really say you should not take wine? Did God really say? See, Adam, David was taking wine. See, the Bible says do not be drunk with wine. Meaning you can drink, don't be drunk. Just drink.
Jesus changed.
Jesus changed. Did God really? See how he twists the scripture? The Bible says that the devil knows there is a God and they tremble.
Yeah.
Usicheze na shaito Buddha. He is 6,000 years older than you. It's like you, eh? It's like you handling my son. Utamu enjoy. Unless I come as a power behind him, utamu enjoy.
That's true.
Tukopoa, are you seeing now the gravity of where we are? So, maja amefanya nini? I'm a user. So dominion has been given.
Thank you.
Okay? Are you seeing that? Mm-hmm. Now, if dominion has been given, it means in the creation, when I created your spirit as Adam, when you have given dominion, you have detached yourself from me. You have now attached yourself to Satan. So we are no longer the same. We are no longer thinking the same. You now have to act as your father, the devil. See, yes, walikuwa nasema hivyo. You are of your father, the devil. I'm going to show you. Yes, yes, walicheza kubwa. Yes, walicheza kama yeye. Wewe usicheze bana. Christ. Tukifika heaven tumgote. Alicheza big. So, Adam, akona nature ya nani sasa? The sin nature. The satanic nature. Okay? So, God now sees. If I allow him to stay in the garden, what will he do? He will eat the tree of life, and I cannot redeem him anymore. So God, because you have a satanic nature, we cannot coexist. Get out. He sends him away. And then what does he do? He places a cherubim to guard against you coming back. So Adam now begins to live life. Are you getting it, Grandma? He begins to live life. He will live 930 something years of spiritual death. Because God has said, the day you will eat of this fruit, you will surely die. But he didn't die.
Yes, only the spirit.
He died in the spirit. He became numb in the spirit. That's why wakati aliza Cain, na story ya Cain Abel. Cain alikuwa root kwa God. Alimuza my brother's keeper, hata ye jipange. That is a satanic nature. That is a satanic nature. That is pride. They didn't have it. Sini kweli. Now if you look at Adam, his generation, come to Noah. Noah is given an instruction to save humanity. After he has done everything, what does he do?
Sleeps.
Ndogio. What did he do? He cast all his children. That is a satanic nature.
What?
Angalia ukuote. Ingi Abraham. Kabulu washipa, mbunu washipa. Side dish. Katoto. Are you seeing now satanic nature in enda kimanifest? Ikimanifest? So in other words, Adam, all the way, are children of wrath. That's what the Bible says in Ephesians.
Yeah.
the children of disobedience. That's what the Bible says. Syria. Now, for Adam, oh, this is gonna bless you. Let me not even go there first. So he has sold himself. Syria. Sita Sahau.
Yes.
He has sold himself. Let's go to Luke. Luke 4. Man, today you are going to go home.
Yes.
And you are going to worship Jesus like never before. You are going to blow him kisses like never before. Mwambie tu, thank you. Thank you for loving me too much. Oh. Luke 4. Then Jesus, being filled with the Holy Ghost, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness. So, there are certain wildernesses that God leads you into. Ukubanga, iko kutubwa mibango ya Yesu, unaingizwa tu. Sawa sawa. So, sazingine kutokosa rent, si yaki mishaito. Sazingine ni God anataka kubuild faith yako. Kanaia ni amen. Hiyo tutakama later on. Tukai kwa redemption. Okay. Being tempted for 40 days by the devil. And in those days, he ate what?
Nothing.
And afterward, when they had ended, he was? And the devil said to him,
if you are
the Son of God, command these stones to become bread. Have you noticed something there?
Yes.
You may notice Kitu. That is after he came from fasting. The devil spoke. So be very careful. Be very careful after you have come out of your prayer closet. Pay attention to the voice of God. That's why you should be familiar with the voice of God. Wakati una fast, unapoko umepiga shaito 10 mil, haezi kugusa. I have seen people who come out of fasting and they sleep around. Bio. For brother. Bio. Watch out. Can I hear better? Amen. That's why we have the grace of God. That's why we have the Spirit of God. And that's why I want to train you to listen to the voice of God. We are going to take some quality teaching on the Holy Spirit. I will teach you how to hear God. Can I hear the amen? So he says, if you are the Son of God, command these stones to become what? So he's questioning Christ's identity. So after a prayer session, the devil will question your identity in Christ. If truly you are a new creation in Christ Jesus, why are you doing this? Why are you doing that? Wow. Can I hear an amen? Then Jesus said, Jesus answered him saying, it is written. Jesus never spoke anything in the head.
Yes.
He spoke the word. It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. Then the devil, this is where I was heading to. Then the devil, verse number 5, taking him up on a high mountain, showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. And the devil said to him, all this authority, are you? All this authority, I will give you and their glory, for this has been what? Delivered to me. Who gave it?
Adam.
Oh, yeah.
Has been delivered to me, and I give it to whoever I wish. Me, I'm the one who give to whoever I wish. That's why you should not be shocked when wicked people have wealth. He gives to whoever he wish. Nataka kukupea, ndakupea. Sasa amekuta Yesu na, listen. And I give to whoever I wish. Therefore, if you will worship before me, all will be yours. Listen, people of God, listen. If this temptation was not true, because Yesu ukisoma kwenye alijibu hapa alisema, and Jesus answered and said, get behind me, Satan. If this temptation was a lie, he would have said, no, dominion is not yours. Jesus recognized, you got it. And that's the reason why I have come for it. Now listen. I'm getting excited because now redemption is making sense.
Listen, he says, therefore, if you worship before me, all will be yours.
Now, can I shock you?
You will always be what you worship.
Wow.
You will always be what you worship. If you esteem money, you will be worshiping money. Money becomes an idol to you. That is why there are sometimes it is difficult for people to tithe. Not because they had some stories there. It's because they worship money. My father in the faith, Pastor Andrew, taught me, don't ever let money be your God. If you feel like you want to hold, give it out. He taught me that. Give it out. Don't let a car be an idol. Don't let your wife be an idol. He says here, therefore, if you will worship before me, all will be yours. Remember, he has said, I give to whoever I will. So any person that worships me is the first person I think about. Then Jesus says, get thee behind me, Satan. All right? For it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only shall you serve. So you can never serve effectively if you're not a worshiper. You cannot serve God effectively if you're not a worshiper. Worship is not something that happens on Sunday, people of God. Worship happens every single day.
Every hour.
Every hour. Get to those alone moments and worship God, because you can I say this?
Yes.
I can tell your heart by the way you serve. I can tell where your heart is from where you serve. You must get to a place that God is so important in your life, nobody else should matter. Can I hear an amen? We want God to do some things to us. Yet we are part-time sons and daughters. And he is a full-time father. Oh, let me not go there. Let me stay on redemption. Can I hear better? Amen. Are you learning something today? So Adam created, he did what? High treason. He gave up authority. That is high treason. It's like you giving secrets to the Ugandan government. That's high treason. That's what he did. Can I hear an amen? Let's look at Psalm 8, verse number 3. Psalm 8, verse number 3. What does the Bible say? When I consider your work, your heavens, this is David speaking, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have ordained. What is man that you are mindful of? The son of man that you visit him. For you have made him a little lower than angels, and you have crowned him with glory and honor, and you have made him to have dominion of the works of your hands. You have put all things under his feet. All sheep and oxen, even the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea that pass through the path of the sea. Oh Lord, how excellent is your name. Even David is wondering. But now, are you together with me? So to me realize, Adam amefanya nini? I'm a blunder. I'm a piano authority. So who has the authority? Who has the authority here? It's the devil. So anytime you see you're getting tendencies, worldly tendencies, it's an attack from the devil. Because now he knows how the system works, and now he's the system. Yeah, the deep state. He's now the system. So anytime you see governments doing funny stuff, it's the arm of the enemy pushing this agenda.
Yes.
Can I hear an amen? Now, understand even what wangu. Redemption has already happened because Christ has become our redemption. But there are parts of redemption that will have to wait. For example, we are redeemed now. We are born again. Christ has become our redemption.
Yeah.
All right? Yes. Whatever Adam sold, Christ has redeemed us. Okay? But we are still in a fallen world. All right? And the Bible says in Revelation 20 that we will have a new heaven and a new earth. Those are new systems of working. So that part is waiting. That's a part waiting for redemption. But redemption yetu shafanyika. But body zetu bado lazima zikuwe redeemed. Juzi unataka kuomba, zinataka kuomba. Unataka kuona movie, spirit man, unataka kuona. You're getting that catalog of war. Your body also needs to be redeemed.
Can I hear an amen? Tuko pamoja?
Yes.
Now, let's go to what? Let's go to, have we looked at Luke chapter 4? Where, yes. Yeah, we read there. So the result of Adam's treason was, we now had physical death, spiritual death, and now there's a second death. Physical death, haikukua. God akuwa maintained Adam akuwe. But mercy yake, sasa now people have to die.
Yeah.
Can I hear an amen? Then when he messed up, he died what? Spiritually. Okay? And now there's a second death where now this body will come out. Then we'll be given the glorified body. Tuko pamoja mpaka hapo? Now let me show you what happened when Adam messed up. Let's go to Romans 1. Are you learning something?
Yes, yes.
All right. Romans chapter 1, verse number 20. Let me read for you. Let's begin from verse number 18. For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who suppress the truth in unrighteousness, because what may be known of God is manifest in them, for God has shown it to them. This is what Apostle Paul is saying. Let me read a couple of scriptures and then I explain. For since the creation of the world, his invisible attributes of who God are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. In other words, there will be nobody that will stand before God to say there is no God.
Yeah.
Even the creation even the creation says he's a God. Even scientists are now agreeing there is a creator behind this thing. Okay? Then the Bible says, because although they knew God, these people, there are people in the world, Mr. Masharia, they know. Wanasikiaga Yesu. Wanajua God yuko. The Bible says, for although they knew God, they did not glorify him as God. They did not set him aside as God. Nor were thankful, but became futile in their thoughts, and their foolish hearts were darkened. That's the nature. Adam and Iweka. Tukifika huko, mangoto. Tunamchapa mangoto. Alright, continue. Professing to be wise. Have you seen these people? They think they are very wise. Professing to be wise. At because I heard one saying, how can you trust a book that came with missionaries?
That's what they say.
Anytime you see people questioning that, it's because they have not had a personal experience with God.
True.
Men, kuna place came unaweza fika na God. Me, I've gotten to those places. Nasikia mwili inaungua. The presence of God is so tangible. Unatetemeka hivi.
Yes.
Yes.
There's some people also are teaching that man has no authority.
Uh-huh.
And then they are saying that when you pray, you're not supposed to say the prayer that you don't have authority.
You have authority. Those are doctrines of devils. Yes, you have authority. Iyo unataka kusuppress iyo wache kuongea. Paul and Silas were singing loudly in prison. Let your authority be the word of God.
Yeah.
And then, nini wote hapa. Even when somebody begins teaching a wrong thing, you will know.
Yeah.
You will tell, iyo mekata. And then also, when I'm teaching very heavy stuff, your head will be like, but your spirit is like, yes, it's true. You're not understanding it, but something in your spirit says, what he's saying is very true. That's your checklist. That is why me personally, they are preachers. They are so big, but I can't listen to them. My checklist with them is not right. Can I hear an amen? Let's continue. So, professing to be wise, they became what? And changed the glory of the incorruptible God into an image made like corruptible men. Unaona knowledge sa zingine inakuwa mbaya. Especially me sijui what happens with people when they go to university. I don't know. It's a system of Kafungala. It's a very bad system. I have never understood when somebody goes to university. They were loving God here. Now they are questioning God. Are you sure God is there? Where, how many voices do you listen to? And me, when you
when I encounter people who are questioning God, I don't waste my time. I don't. We can't argue. One person was telling me, you come. We were debating on my WhatsApp. Then he told me, don't quote the Bible. I told him, if I don't quote the Bible, I don't have anything to argue with you. If I can't take you to the Bible, then you stay with your faith, I stay with mine. Can I hear a better amen?
Amen?
By the way, there are some people, the Bible says, deliver them to Satan. Yes, the Bible says, deliver them to Satan. Mpeane. And you also look at it. Unajua ka eti sana kwa roshaka wanasema, hey, Mungu kuja. Now they can listen.
Yeah.
Exactly. Like my son, if I tell my son, usiguze socket ya stima. Guza. Guza. Bewa. Siku ingine ukiona electric shock, utaionea idini huko. Can I hear better amen?
Amen?
You can never understand this thing logically.
Yes.
Scientifically, he keeps his marks. Faith is science. Faith ni endo wambia God. Iki tupasia na sema. God si mwoni wambia eh. Sasa tani niambia ni yelewile. Imo tu. God, I want to understand what Pasi understands. Because I'm also growing. I'm also learning these things. Yeah? You can also learn. Eh? By the way, msiye yata enda kwa wagi na Waislamu. Ati akasema. Hapana. The best way for a believer to prove God is there is by results. Results. Where could I na Muislamu kiwete? Mwambia muka. Aha, you don't know. You're joking. Ataita watu. Atawaita ina. And I hear an amen. And I usually say these people of God, don't fight for the word. The word fights for itself.
Yes.
Don't.
The
yes. You see, like me as your pastor, my work is to give you the truth. Ukika uone, pasi, hii neno unatupeleka kwa dhambi sana. Hiyo ni hapo. Mimi nafanya assignment yangu. Mungu aliniambia hii ndio nafanya waambie. Na hii ndio itakuokoa. I tell you, hiyo kutapika hapa, tutachafua kanisa bwana. Hakuna haja tuchafue kanisa, si ndio? Si ndio wapendwa? Afadhali nikupe ukweli. Hii ukweli ndio ina deliver. Kile kuwekelewa mkono unaenda huko 2 weeks later unakuja ati wamekuja na majirani wangapi? Watatu. Wako wapi kwa mkono? Wamefanya nini? Hapana. Ati ingieni kwa basi, endeni endeni chukueni milango. Dude, we don't have that time. Can I hear an amen? So, let's continue.
Therefore,
God also gave them up to
sinful desires.
If we imagine that is in the New Testament, as in God amejaribu all he can, but you are defiant. The Bible says God gives you to your pleasures. Hey, are you listening? So, there are people God has already graced them. God amekuambia, Buddha, wachana na hiki. Wachana na hiki. Wachana na hiki. Anakupeana. Chukua sasa. Me, I dread the day Mungu atanipeana. Me, staki, anipeana. Maybe the obedient. There are people that are clubbing right now because walijipeana. Na Buddha hata niwaambie, ukisha jipeana, shaito amepewa mhuri. Unafikiria Job was the specimen. Where you can cross. Mwanzia takufanyia maneno. This guy is ruthless. This guy. Do you know it is only the believers in your heart who gravity at the enemy? If you have ever heard stories of the other side, loyalty is loyalty. You are given an assignment, you mess, you are dead. That's the guy when you are jaribi kutempt. That is why you should. Yes, what is saying, watch and pray. Watch and pray. Pray and watch. Chungulia.
Kamacho.
Can I hear a better amen? I'm helping somebody here.
Amen.
Already, he's under our feet. But don't get so comfortable. Don't get so comfortable. Eh, ata anakupiga sweet, unasema ata ya shaitani. Sweet says a kidogo. No, don't be comfortable. Can I hear an amen?
Alright. Therefore, God also gave them up to uncleanness in the lust of their hearts, to dishonor their body amongst themselves, who exchanged the truth of God for the lie and worshipped this and served the creature rather than the creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. For this reason, God gave them up to vile passion. He has given them voice. Please, may I look at your scripture? For this reason, God gave them up to vile passion. For even their women exchanged the natural use for what is against nature. In other words, it is unnatural for a woman to sleep with a woman, for a man to sleep with a man. So they gave themselves to those passions. So, likewise, also the men, leaving the natural use of a woman, burnt in their lust for another man. That is a satanic nature. I go, did you come on your creation? Walijua kuna God. Wakamkata. They were not thankful. They did not esteem him. Then professing to be wise, my professor, my PhD, manini, manini. We have accomplished this. We are now self-sufficient. Now God is out of the picture. Because now God is out of the picture, God cannot help these human beings. So anything they think about, they do. So God and honor, okay, you don't need me. Okay, have them. Have them. You don't want to do business the right way. Okay, do it. Bribe your way. Let's continue. Likewise, also the men living the natural use of the woman, burnt in their lust for another one another, men with men, committing what is shameful, and receiving in themselves the penalty of their error which was due. And even they, as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge. In other words, even in school, we have to retain God in school. We have to retain God in colleges, in universities. And if those schools are not doing it, it's your duty as a parent to retain God. Can I hear an amen? God gave them over to a debased mind. Nani yako na version flani na sema different na yang? Verse 28. Even as they did not,
furthermore, since they did not think it worthwhile to attain the knowledge of God, he gave them over to a depraved mind.
Depraved.
To do what ought not to be done.
God has given you the first time, the second time, now he gives you a depraved mind. Kichwa ifikiri. Wow. The best mind to do those things which are not fitting. Being filled, let's read verse 29. Being filled with all unrighteousness, sexual immorality, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, strife, deceit, evil-mindedness. Yani, sorry, are you seeing this? Evil-mindedness. As in, unaka hivi, when somebody is meditating on the word, if you are meditating on evil, nini tunaweza fanya hapa? Twende polisi tuwashe moto. Evil mind. Akademika amepita. Si tukapite nako. Evil mind. Yani, somebody is meditating on the word. Another one is meditating on evil. Nini hatujafanya? Imagine. Tuko wapi grace? Backbiters, verse 30. Backbiters. Haters of God. Look at that. Haters of God. And what's the tenor? Backbiters, haters of God, violent, proud, boasters, inventors of what?
Evil things.
What are you doing?
What I invent, it will shock the devil. Till it comes good.
You do crazy stuff. They do an ordination ceremony.
For you.
Bishop so and so. The bishop of evil things. Inventors of evil. In other words, people of God, you have not seen evil yet. They are still inventing. You have not seen evil yet. That's how a depraved, that is what Adam did. That is the cause of Adam. Inventors of evil. When you both clear evolution, clear your day. You are able to clear, they are still inventing. It is, that is what the devil can. You give him the seed, he becomes the driver. The devil. Many have seen, me have been in ministry for close to 20 years. I have seen with my eyes crazy stuff. I have seen somebody leaving their wife, Evie. Yani, na ataki kusikia. I have seen with my eyes. Can I hear a better amen? That is why you should watch out. You don't come out of authority, out of accountability system. Mtu anaweza kukuambia, you are messing up. You are messing. Lakini ukikuwa an end to yourself, oh, you will see and know. And consider and understand together. Okay, inventors of evil. Disobedient to parents, undiscerning, untrustworthy. Have you been encountering such people? Unloving, unforgiving, unmerciful, who knowing the righteous judgment of God, that those who practice such things are deserving of death, not only do the same, but also approve or encourage others to do it.
That makes a lot of sense.
It does.
You have explained a lot.
Now you know. Now you know what we are against. So that is what Adam took us into. But thanks be to God for Jesus. Because this is where ile point tulisema ni sasa, this is where I was heading to. I went ahead of myself. This is where I was heading to. So if Adam gave authority to the devil, Adam cannot get back the authority. Adam needs a higher authority than the devil. Get it. Okay?
Yes.
So there is a talk in heaven. The Father and the Son are saying, now you will you go? He says, I will go as long as the Holy Spirit goes with me. Because I cannot resurrect without the Spirit of God. You remember that? So Jesus comes. He is walking. He is tempted by the devil. But Jesus begins to show us redemption for the poor in the four Gospels. Can I hear an amen? So in the four Gospels, the disciples wanapata mtu ni msiku, wanamuuliza, ni nani alikosea, nani alisini. Nakumbuka? Is it the Baba or the Mother? Yesu naye akasema, hii may happen, ndio Mungu akuwe glorified. That's redemption. Yesu wanakutana na a woman caught in the act. Ujio ndio akuwe caught in the act, alikuwa akapela, ana ene, na ameletwa na wasi. Yesu anachora chini, wanamuuliza, okay, huyu tumfanyia aje? Akasema aje, mwenye akona sin, ana sin, akuwe wa kwanza kutupa mawe. Sijui kama usha soma hiyo Bible, nasema aje, walitoka from the oldest to the youngest, so kulikuwa na tuboy hapo, waliishia. Yesu akauliza aje, watu wenye walikuwa na kuakizwa kwa wapi? Wameenda. Akasema aje, neither do I condemn you, I have redeemed you.
There's no condemnation.
No condemnation. Yeah. I have redeemed you. Can I hear better amen? I tell you, you should love Jesus with all of your heart.
Amen.
Men, what Jesus did for us, atungetoka from, the reason why you are now thankful, the reason why is it, you are not an inventor of sin. It's because of Jesus. The reason why you are what? You don't have a debased mind. Do you know now you have the mind of Christ?
Yes.
Imagine. The reason why now God has not given us to I'm a
wow.
Because of Jesus.
Oh, yes.
Can I hear a better amen?
Amen.
Can I hear a better amen?
Amen.
Now, in Revelation 20:10, let me just read for you. The devil who deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophets are. So you see where the false prophets are going? How do I identify a false prophet? Any teaching. What did I say? Any teaching that never glorifies Christ is a false teaching.
Can you give me an example?
Let me finish preaching. I will think about what. I'm so much into Christ, I can't even think.
I don't know how the false do.
I don't know how to fix it. Man. See, that's good for your pastor. Alright? And they will be tormented day and night forever and ever. Then I saw a great white throne and him who sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away, and there was found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great. That's why we should win souls. Listen, small and great. So there will be great people in hell. There will be small people in hell. Standing before God, and books were opened. And another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged according to their works, by the things which were written in the books. So, what are we going to be judged? Our works. Our works. What did you do with the gospel? What did you do with the knowledge of Christ? What did you do with the assignment I gave you? Can I hear an amen? This should make you wake up very early in the morning and do the work of God. Can I hear an amen? All right. Verse 13, the sea gave up the dead who were in it, and death and Hades delivered up the dead who were in them. And they were judged, each one according to his works. See, you're not being judged here, you as a believer, whether you received Christ or not. Isha Peter, you are now judged with what did you do after you received Christ?
The assignment.
The assignment. Yeah. And this thing, by the way, can I bring it home? This thing is so serious. Christ atakuwa nakuuliza. Unakumbuka siku fulani ulipanda mati? Ulikuwa unaenda mali fulani? You sat next to a sister, alikuwa nalia, that soul, I needed in the kingdom. What did you do? Okay, wewe utaenda hell, but utakuwa na ka crown. So maybe kakofia kako katakuwa kanyota. Unabai? Unapitana rinagoke, yaki likubwa, ineshikiliwa. Oh, may God have mercy on us. Heaven utaingia. Iyo si, heaven unaingia. But sasa works. Christ anakuambia, you see, that lady went to hell. What did you do? Christ anasema, you remember you had a Jesus conference? Yes. And I prepared it for you. I had this in mind. Because I saw your life was going this way. And that conference will take your direction this way, the way I wanted. You never went there. What were you doing? And I had told you to take another sister to go with her to church. Wow. Can I hear better amen? Then death and Hades were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And anyone not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. Now, can I even shock you? I will not explain it, but in the course of us meeting, I will explain it. This book of life, the names are already written. They're already written.
Yes.
God does not write your name because you got born again today. It is already written. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, took how many population? 7.2 billion. So the book has 7.2 billion names written. When you die because you did not receive Christ, it is taken away.
What?
Let me give you an example. Moses. Nani? Alisema aje, if you do not go with us, take me away from this land, from the book of life. Oh. Moses said it.
Oh, so that...
Yes. Ako. Every person is in the book. But at the point of death, if you did not accept Christ, it is taken away. And that is what we call grace. If it makes sense, Moses alisema, Buddha, kama tuwe ni towa jina yangu from the book of life. Alijuaje hiko? Alijuaje hiko? The Father is so gracious, kila mtu wako kwa hiyo kitabu. But ukidieti kama ujui Christ, anatoa. Oh, may God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So I close with Romans 5.
Have I given you some stuff to think about? I saw Ken wrote something on WhatsApp. I think ulikimbia. Ulichapona your revelation of ulikimbia. Alright. Okay. Romans 5. Therefore, having been justified by faith. So how are we justified?
By
faith. We now have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom also we have access by faith into this grace in which we stand and rejoice in hope of glory of God. And not only that, but we also glory in tribulations. Continue. Knowing that tribulations produces perseverance. So sa zingine kupitia, what is it producing? Some perseverance, some self-control. Right? You are a spendthrift. So sometimes katap kanafungwa, you watch a kukua. Yeah. God anakwambia, hey, this money is for your rent for next nini. Unasema, I will not lack anything. Na tunapoa spiritual. Okay, let's continue. And perseverance, character. So unafinyo sali, ndio pole self-control. Because God anabina na character yako. Can I help you, people of God? There are two ways of learning in life. Either present yourself to learn lessons, or you'll be presented in the fire. The fire furnace. Your choice. Can I hear an amen? Let's continue. And character hope. Now hope does not disappoint because the love of God has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Ghost who was given to us. So each and every one of us has the ability to love people. Say, I have the ability, to love people. Including your caretaker. Including that employee of yours you can't stomach. Why do they say you can't stomach? You can't shoulder, okay. For when we were still without strength, in due time, Christ died for the ungodly. That is ransom. That is redemption. He died for the ungodly. Twendeleni.
For
a righteous man in one die, then perhaps for a good man, someone would even dare to die. But God demonstrated his love towards us. See, love can be demonstrated. We can see love.
Yes, we can see love. Yes.
You don't say you love somebody and you don't demonstrate. And grace, you should demonstrate more. Because I see you want to tell people to buy you lunch. Demonstrate more. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Alright. That while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. That is redemption. Much more than, having now been justified by his blood, we shall be saved from the wrath through him. Now listen. I'm closing. Listen. Can you give me 5 minutes?
Yes.
In the Old Testament, the wrath of God was against what? Sin. What Adam did. In the New Testament, the wrath of God is for any person that does not believe in Christ. Yes. So the wrath of God right now is to anybody that doesn't accept his sacrifice, the sacrifice of his son. Okay? To understand? Verse number 5, 10. For if when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his son, much more, having been reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. So the redemption is coming through the life of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. And not only that, but we also rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received
the reconciliation,
about the atonement, about the redemption. Can I hear the amen? Verse 12, therefore, just as through one man sin entered, so sin ilikuwa, it entered through one man. Sin ilikuwa? And death through sin, and thus death spread to all men. This death is spiritual death. Are you getting it?
Oh yeah, that's for all.
Because all sin. For until the law, sin was in the world. But sin is not imputed where there is no law. I have always explained this. Ukikuta hapa kesho kuna traffic lights, it means there is an introduction of a law. So if you break that law, you are a law breaker. But before kukwenda hiyo traffic light, there was no law. So you are not breaking any law. So it tells us there was sin in the time of Adam until God said, don't take this and that. Okay.
Tuendele. Nevertheless, death reigned, that's verse 14. Death reigned from Adam to Moses. So Adam to Moses was spiritually dead.
What?
Yes. They were spiritually dead. We are the people that, we are the generation that has the spiritual liveness in us because of Jesus. Tuendele, tuendele, tuendele fei. Kuna nyole kabisa, tuendele. All right. Even over those who had not sinned according to the likeness of the transgression of Adam, who is a type of him who was to come. Because we have a first Adam that sinned, we have a last Adam that is Christ. Takuonesha kwa scripture. But the free gift, to go happy grace? 15. Continue. But the free gift is not like the offense. For if by one man's offense many died, much more the grace of God and the gift by the grace of the one man Jesus Christ abounded to many. And the gift is not like that which came through the one who sinned. For the judgment which came from one offense resulted in condemnation. But the free gift which came from many offenses resulted in justification. Now we are justified. He's trying to contrast Adam and Jesus. Are you seeing that?
Yes.
All right, 29. For if by the one man's offense death reigned through one, much more those who receive abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness will reign in life through the one. So we reign in life through the gift of righteousness and through the grace of God and through Christ. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
All right, 29. Yeah, 18. Therefore, as through one man's offense judgment came to all men, resulting in condemnation, even so through one man's righteous act, the free gift came to all men, resulting in the justification of life. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
So, Jesus became the payment. Adam sold. Remember the definition of redemption?
Yes.
He sold it away. Jesus bought it back. Can I hear an amen? So, I close with this question. Are you the redeemed?
Yes.
Think slowly. Are you the redeemed? Are you the redeemed?
Yes.
Wow. Are you the redeemed?
Yeah.
Turn to Galatians 4:4. Let the scriptures tell us.
It's a trick question.
Galatians 4:4. Let's begin from 4:1. Now, I say that the heir, as long as he's a child, does not differ at all from a slave, though he's a master of all, okay? But he's under guardians and stewards until the time appointed by the Father. So, it is your spiritual growth that now gives you your inheritance. See you? Alright, to sum it, verse number 3, 1-2, go. Even so, we, when we were children, were in bondage under the elements of the world. But when the fullness of the time had come, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under what?
Law.
Born under what?
Law.
So Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John are still what?
Law.
Wow. Good students.
Wow.
Continue reading. Born under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. And because you are sons, God has sent forth the spirit of his son into your hearts, crying, Abba Father. Alright. Now, Jesus took back what Adam lost. See, wait. Then, we have seen in the Old Testament, God will redeem his people. They will sell themselves, he will redeem them. See, wait. Then there was the introduction of the law. It was a way of also redeeming yourself. That's why David now comes and says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. But you're forgetting you're a Gentile. You are not a Jew. You're a Gentile. So me and you are not the redeemed. We are the fruits of redemption.
Yes!
We are not the redeemed. We are the fruit of what Jesus did.
Yes.
We were not even part of this thing. Aki kujiita, iki to require my Jews. So by His grace and mercy, glory to God. Now we are the fruit of redemption. Father, we thank you. Let's worship you. Father, we thank you. We worship you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for being our redemption. Thank you for thinking about us. Thank you for revealing yourself to us, O God. Thank you, mighty God. We worship you, mighty Father. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Jesus. We honor you, mighty God, for what you did on the cross. Now we have your wisdom. We have your righteousness. We have your sanctification. We love you, Jesus. Thank you for being our redemption. Thank you, mighty God.